It's the coffee. I drank it too fast.
Maybe it's the milk.
I don't use milk.
All right.
Oh, man.
You never afford it. Okay, that was Brian Adams. He's our Sergeant of Arms. This is Stephanie
Raptis.
She's our recording secretary.
Corresponding.
Okay, you're off to a good start,
he's
Joe.
This sends out the email. How many people are looking in on the 49th Precinct Council sheet? Yeah. Okay, he's going to give it to you later to make sure. And you can get some up to date information just by tuning in on that page. So, Sylvia Mazzella is our vice president.
Standing
officer, Captain Alps. And this gentleman is Captain Ordonez.
What'd you eat today? What'd you eat anyway?
No, it's not that, it's the coffee.
Did you have it black?
No, it was the black. Okay.
Steve Sermon, Head of Community Affairs.
I think I drank it too fast.
Dave Ward, Community Affairs Officer, Detective. Andrea Siegel, she's our Assistant Secretary. And Kay Cardona, she's a So, tonight, we're going to go and we're going to look at our election, process. We'll also take nominations from the floor. The chairperson of that committee will stand up at the end of the meeting and give you an overlay of what's going to happen and how it happens and why it happens. So, Tyrone Modesto.
Madeiros.
Usually I get the
A wrong. Could you do this real quick? I don't want to go to the bathroom.
For my dinner.
Just point. It's right on.
And that's our system. Okay. First thing we're going to do is we're going to hear from Captain Alps. He's going to give us a rundown on what's been going on in our communities and also present a cop of the month. Captain Alps,
you. Well, I appreciate everyone coming out tonight in the rainy nights. It shows what a great community we have, very involved. So I thank you for coming out. Please announce Captain Ordonez is by my side. 31 years of experience. As a command, we're doing well. We're down in crime year to date. We're down 7.1%. The only seven major problems, and that is driven primarily by domestic violence. I said this repeatedly at many community council meetings. So we have 16 additional felony assaults compared to last year. So overall, we're doing very well in crime. What I like to do is, when I have the community council meetings, I like to talk about the community. I don't know areas specifically, what my area is. So almost every area, Van Ness, Morris Park, Helen Gardens, everyone's seen a decrease in crime. Everyone. Morris Park has seen a significant decrease in crime. This year, they've only had 62 seven majors reported. Last year, they had 94 this time last year. That's a big decrease. And that's seen a decrease as well, 100 versus 108, so 80 less crimes. Still concerned about burglaries and car breakings down in the Van Ness area. You have five more burglaries this year compared to last year. There's an individual that we're still looking for, Vince Rosario. I spoke about him in past community council meetings. He wanted for a burglary. So we'll be passing that one to fly around. He's someone in the Van Ness area that's hitting the resident. Again, Morris Park's doing great. Pelham Gardens, which is basically Allerton to Pelham. This is what I'm calling it. Allerton to Pelham, Hutch to Williamsbridge Road. Seen decrease in crime, two less crime. 41 versus 43. Pelham Garden usually accounts for about 12% of the overall crime in command. And that's where it's on pace, same amount. Allerton is a different story. We have issues up in Allerton. And it's always been a focus of mine. I've always said this, everything west of Williamsbridge Road is my focus, where my crime is. West of Williamsbridge Road is accounting for about 70% of the overall crime in command. 70%. So my resources are geared in that area. When we talk about Allerton, Allerton, crime's going to happen up in Allerton. It's going to be a robbery. That's my concern up there. So right now, year to date, 113 crimes in Allerton versus 95 last year. So that's 18 additional crimes compared to last year. I was looking at those 18. 11 of them are domestic felonies. Okay. And nine. We also have 9 additional burglaries. So the robberies have decreased by 1 in Allerton. Burglaries have decreased by 3, and the DLAs are down by 2. So Allerton is the turn of line, and also Venice. So we just got 2 folks in the area. I put a car down in Van Ness, called Van Ness Auto, pulling it for the overnight hours to keep you guys safe down there. And combat the burglaries. We haven't had a burglary down there on the wood for a bit, so we're going to catch up and do a little well. East Chester, California area is 39 versus 42 for index crime, so we're down 3 up in California, East Chester area. But that's the one area where I took, non-fatal shooting. And that was in these sets of houses, which we, again, we talked about that, we made an arrest. Again, domestic violence accounts for about 15.8% of the crime in command, and domestic violence also accounts for about 51% of our felony assaults in command. So when you look at, you know, the crimes, CompStat page, and you see 85 felony assaults, you know, and that 42 of them are domestic violence. So we have a lot of work to do. We had a lot of workshop at the command today. We had the Explorers, a lot of youth turned out. It's great to see them. They're an inspiration to me today. I tell you, they're involved. Unlike my generation, I was just talking about this with Jamie Babe. The youth today are just amazing. They're involved, they're engaged. They came out to this workshop. There's probably about 30 of them at least. In all different areas of the command, we talk about domestic violence and how it's, you know, it's almost like a psycho violence. You know, it's learned behavior. And when these kids are seeing violence in home, when they grow up, it might perpetuate and continues. And so we provide strategies to combat domestic violence, and we had some a workshop and a scenario, and service providers available, because we know a lot of this violence in homes has underlying issues, whether it's mental health or stuff like that. So it was a good educational experience, and I appreciate the kids showing up and giving us support. So again, crime is doing well. There's some significant incidents you may have not seen, may have or may not have seen in the media. I'm sure you probably have some questions about. You know, we We had an arrest at 1741 Colton Avenue where 10 individuals were arrested for gambling location. It's like a social club after hours location. Received the tip and we did surveillance outside. We made 10 arrests. Some people may view that what's a big deal? They're in this place. They're just socializing and having a few drinks and the game on the side. Well, I see it in a different way, and some people in the community see it a different way. Attractive element can be problematic. You have large quantities of money on a table in an open area. You can have people with bad intent and violence come in and maybe rob the location. That's a problem. When you're serving alcohol and you're buying with this gambling activity that's all unregulated, it can cause issues and violence within the people that are there. So it was a big win. Lieutenant Hickman did that operation. My right-hand man, I tell you, when I need something executed, he gets it done. No gifts, ends, or buts. He's executed. He's an asset to the precinct, and he's doing it. Great work, so I appreciate that. The other thing you've seen in the paper was the grow house at 1723 Fowler. Excellent work by our intel team that received the tip. Investigated it, did what we call knock and talk, knock on the door. They engaged the occupant of the house. They see Crocker King in plain view, and they go down and they swear out a search warrant, which allows us to search the whole premises. We make our way up to the second floor. You can smell a strong odor of marijuana. Overwhelming. We get up to the second floor, and there's four rooms divided up. And it was an elaborate system where the walls were insulated. They had tapped into the electrical system, bypassing the meter so Con Ed wouldn't register the amount of electricity they were drawing, so they could supply energy and lighting and heat to the upper floor to harvest these plants. What was growing up there was marijuana in various stages. So they also tapped into the water lines, which we got to look into the DEP. See what was going on with that, but I'll tell you, the individual that built this system was pretty skilled. Shame he didn't put it into a positive, method. But it was very elaborate. We ended up cutting down the plants. We're approximating about 50 pounds of marijuana. Street value, I don't know, maybe $1,000. New York guy, we gotta look into that. But the individual was placed under arrest, food bill, grand jury. He was charged with felony possession of marijuana. So that's a good thing. He was on parole for burglary. He had absconded from parole and he was missing for about 4 years. So that's a big, big win for the community, Morris Park. I happened to notice an article out in Sacramento about a grow house. Some people are saying, what's a big deal, marijuana? Okay. Well, there was a grow house in marijuana. What happens is, apparently, there's a home invasion and there's a shooting and two people are killed. Mm-hmm. What happens is, when you have these marijuana grow houses, are you dealing in large amounts of marijuana and also dealing in a large amount of cash? When you're dealing with a large amount of cash, kind of like a gambling spot, you have to protect your spot. What are you going to have? You're going to have guns. And then violence leads to violence. It's not necessarily the marijuana that it's the trade. And plus that individual, Paul Scanner, a burglary. He did at least four or five burglaries prior. So that was a big win for the community. Excellent job by Intel. I'm very proud about that. Some other significant arrests. I'll just go down real quick. We had a graffiti arrest. I love it. Anti-crime, down in the Van Ness area, right? So, big win. And it was a shame. it came at the perfect time, and White Plains rolled a long scale, plain clothes cops, rolled by, the guys were springing up, and it was a good artwork, but it wasn't legal. That's what they call it, graffiti. Graffiti is illegal. Artwork is legal. So I roll up and I grab them, hands wet, whole nine yards. So they're placed under arrest. The next day we had a cleanup scheduled. I was looking forward to painting over that one the next day. It would have been a great quick response, but we'll do it this weekend. We'll speak about that. We've got the cleanup schedule. We've got 21 spots. And another mailbox is definitely cleaning up. It's going to be good. So we're doing good with the community. I spoke about several past community meetings about the LA fitness pattern. The guy was breaking into the lockers, stealing credit cards and wallets, and wanted an old bird, Staten Island, Queens, Bronx, several commands in the Bronx, and he's killing us. Yeah, he did this about several times. Post warrants, locates him in a residence of 4-6, they execute, he jumps out the window.
One.
He injures himself, but he's under arrest. So they dropped, I want to say, 7, 8, 9, 15 arrest numbers on him. Very bad dude, so I'm glad we removed him. No longer our problem. Spoke about another individual, domestic violence related, one is Jason. I'm at a Far Side house, repeatedly beat his girlfriend, robbing her. We were doing a lot of robberies and assaults up in the California area because of this individual. Bronx wants, goes out to New Jersey, they locate him out in East Orange, and they actually got him back here to New York. They dropped seven online on him, seven arrest numbers on him, three robberies, one criminal possession of a weapon, the unauthorized use, violation of the section of grand marshal. Big win getting them off. You're relocating the gun. It's become so problematic. We reached out to the Portugal office, right? And to get her relocated. So that was a big win. Van Ness. We located Vision Rosario's partner who's doing a burglary down there. He's got 62 priors. We took him off. We arrested him 2 weeks ago. And we arrested him. So that's one guy we got in the man. He's got to get Vision Rosario. That's his partner. Talk about two incidents of concern to me. We had shots fired. They shot fired in the Pelham houses. I was working at night in the middle of the Pelham houses. Shot spotter comes over. We talk about shot spotter. Three shots. area. There was no ballistics. There might have been a time where we would have been like, someone got hit, no ballistics, no fun. Not today. All officers did extensive camera canvas. They located cameras which captured three individuals that were investigating for the shots fired. Again, we don't have any ballistics. Again, we have no victim, but we are investigating these three individuals. And it just shows that these guys take this very seriously and they're digging deep to stop the violence. Lastly, so we all got these department phones. My phone is specifically set for a specific type of job, so I get alerted to them. Mm-hmm. And it's a funny noise. So about 2:30 in the morning on Sunday, it makes a sound noise and wakes me up. What's this? And I see shots fired. Well, it's a shot spotter activation. Again, my shot spotter is working well. Shot spotter is basically everything you want to call it. We got a shot spotter notification, 2500 points in the wall. So the guys get on scene, they do a canvas, they locate ballistics at 2500. We do an investigation, and it leads back to an establishment on Boston Road. The owner of that establishment came in, spoke to me on Monday. He explained to me that the incident started in his establishment. It's a licensed premise. He explained to me he immediately dispersed these individuals. They were arguing, this verbal argument, and then these individuals proceeded to go up the block and gunfire up. I believe the owner of the establishment, he's working with us. I gave him suggestions on how he can help me prevent any of this type of activity or this violence. He actually gave me some suggestions. On top of that, I hope he will follow up on that. But I trust him, and I think it's going to work. That being said, we're going to have police presence outside the establishment during that what we call the witching hour, 2-3 o'clock, to make sure that nobody is being violence coming out. So we have to prevent this. I want this community safe, and I want businesses to thrive. This isn't a one-way street. I'm not looking to hurt anyone, but I also want to protect the community that we serve. And if the business isn't playing its part, I have to do it. But I trust this individual. I think he's going to do the right thing, and he's going to be in trouble. Outside of that, I think we're doing well. I think we're going to continue to do well. Thank you. Now, we got a new officer in a month.